Welcome to Brilliant Corners. My name's Thomas Wendt, and on behalf of Lighthouse Arts, Inc., we welcome you to our online series. For more episodes like this, as well as other content, visit our website, lighthouseartsmusic.org. You can also follow us on social media, on Facebook and Instagram, at Lighthouse Arts, Inc. The old saying, a jack of all trades, master of none, certainly applies to most of us. But not when you're talking about trumpeter, composer, arranger, and band leader Thad Jones. He was a master of all of these musical trades. Most people know Thad from the groundbreaking big band he co-led with drummer Mel Lewis. But there's much more to Thad Jones than just big bands. Born on March 28th of 1923, Thad was the middle brother of the great Jones Triumvirate from Pontiac, Michigan. His older brother, pianist Hank, would become the dean of the jazz pianists, while younger brother, drummer Elvin, would completely change the way drummers approached their instrument. Thad made equally great musical contributions, but did so blazing his own personal path to success. After serving in the military from 1943 to 1946, Thad led various jazz groups in and around Detroit, including a residency at the legendary Bluebird Club with saxophonist Billy Mitchell. His first recordings were made during this era in the earliest 1950s in Detroit, including one session that featured a young singer named Jackie Wilson. In May of 1954, Thad made the move to New York City to join the newly reformed Count Basie Orchestra. But Basie wasn't the only band leader who had their eye and ear on Jones. Bassist Charles Mingus was so impressed by Thad that he gave him his first record date for Debut Records, the label Mingus co-founded with drummer Max Roach. On March 13th of 1956, Thad Jones began recording for the still young and developing Blue Note Records, a label that would go on to record some of the most important American music ever made. For his first session, he surrounded himself with some of his most capable hometown colleagues, saxophonist Billy Mitchell, guitarist Kenny Burrell, and a young pianist named Tommy Flanagan. Rounding out the rhythm section were two of New York's finest, bassist Oscar Pettiford and former Basie drummer Shadow Wilson. This session has the distinction of being one of the very few Blue Note dates not done at the Hackensack, New Jersey studio of engineer Rudy Van Gelder. Instead, this session was done at Audio Video Studio in Manhattan. The record is appropriately titled Detroit, New York Junction. Let's hear some of the music from this date. Here's Thad's original composition, Zek. This tune, Zek, was named for the featured saxophonist Billy Mitchell, as he was in charge of all of the business for the group back in Detroit. This earned him the nickname, The Executive. Thad's compositions provide us some of the very best examples of how to be unique as a composer while still both respecting tradition and remaining interesting to all listeners, musicians and non-musicians alike. Indeed, his music had something for everyone. Let's check out another one of Thad's tunes from this session. Here's one he calls Scratch. Thad would go back into the studio again for Blue Note on July 14th of 1956, this time at the famed Van Gelder studio. Also this time around, he's with a totally new rhythm section, consisting of pianist and fellow Detroiter Barry Harris, bassist Percy Heath, who was a new member at that time of the Modern Jazz Quartet, and the one and only Max Roach on drums, whose musical partner Clifford Brown had died just 2.5 weeks earlier on the Pennsylvania Turnpike. This album, titled The Magnificent Thad Jones, features more American songbook standards than his other albums on Blue Note, but we're still treated to a couple of Jones originals. This one's called Thadia, penned for his daughter. Check this one out. Fortunate for us that Thad made time to record these albums during this era. In the mid-late 50s, Count Basie was enjoying the beginning of his great second act, and Thad was an integral part of the Basie brass section. He was also busy writing and arranging for Basie as well. On February 2nd, 1957, Thad entered the Van Gelder studio for the final time for Blue Note in the 1950s. For this session, he had fellow Basieite Benny Powell on trombone, Gigi Grice on alto saxophone, another great Detroit pianist, Tommy Flanagan, the veteran of the session, bassist George DeVivier, and Thad's younger brother, Elvin, on drums. Here's a Jones original from this session entitled Thad Rack. Before we go, let's check out one more from this session. Pianist Tommy Flanagan did a great job of keeping Thad's small group music alive during the final years of his career. One tune of Thad's that Tommy loved to play was one called Let's, which became something of a fixture in his repertoire. So let's hear Let's. Thad Jones would leave Count Basie in early 1963, spending the next few years freelancing in New York, participating in many great bands and recording sessions. And then in 1966, he joined forces with drummer Mel Lewis to create the Thad Jones Mel Lewis Orchestra. And as they say, the rest is history. But these early leader dates on Blue Note really showcase Thad's abilities as a true triple threat. His writing and arranging, Both have a distinct sound utilizing original chord changes and melodies that anyone can enjoy. And his voice on the trumpet is like no other. Thad has never gotten his due as the truly masterful improviser he was. These records showcase all of this, and it was just the beginning. Thad would go on to make small group records for the United Artists and Roulette labels in the early 60s. As always, I hope you've enjoyed checking this music out as much as I have. These are some of my favorite all-time records from this era. You can find our accompanying listening list for this episode at lighthouseartsmusic.org. Thanks again. I'll look forward to seeing you next time. Take care. Thanks so much for joining us today on Brilliant Corners. For more episodes like this, as well as other content, visit our website, lighthouseartsmusic.org, and follow us on social media on Facebook and Instagram at Lighthouse Arts Inc. We hope to see you again soon, but in the meantime, stay safe and stay close to the music.